history of our sport. We'll get it on one more time, a match we never thought we'd see. You'll see it, and Halloween Havoc, Hogan against Warrior.
Well, it's going to happen. If I was the Warrior, I think I would have thrown the Disciple right back down to Hogan.
Well, what a threat by the Warrior. He claims that he started with the Disciple, Hogan's most committed follower, but that's just the beginning. He's going to take all the possessions that Hollywood Hogan believes have value, and he's starting with the Disciple.
You know, he warned Hogan to beware tonight. Obviously, the Warrior isn't done with Hollywood Hulk Hogan. This is going to get interesting.
Grant makes his way out, fans. Don't forget, we understand Ric Flair is here with us tonight. We'll be hearing from him live on this program. In addition, we talked about our feature bout. We're going to see a little bit later on. It's going to be Scott Hall and Stevie Ray together once again against the total package Lex Luger and Big Sexy Kevin Nash. A lot of stories there as well. We can talk about the condition of Scott Hall, who obviously, as we saw at the top of the program, has arrived in the same condition that we saw him last time on this program.
I just wonder if Scott Hall and Stevie Ray are going to be able to coexist as tag team partners. Yes, they're both members of NWO Black and White, but after we saw last Thursday on Thunder, the problems that they had as a tag team, I wonder if they're going to be both on the same page or not.
I'll tell you, combine the fact that Flair is here, we're going to have a big tag team main event. We know the Warrior is in the arena, although we never know where he's going to make an appearance. Hollywood Hogan is here. So, you know, look at that massive wheel by Wrath against Nick Dinsmore here. You never know when the Warrior's going to make another appearance or what he's going to do in the seemingly endless mind games that really has Hogan nothing less than sideways.
Sideways? Hogan is scared stiff.
One other question. Who the Warrior might take next? What's the next possession of Hollywood Hogan?
You don't think paranoia is spreading throughout the members of Team Hollywood, do you?
I think it started a couple of weeks ago, didn't it?
Anytime you have the big egos and things such as that, you're going to have paranoia. Paranoia, I think, was there before the Warrior arrived, but heightened when the Warrior made his appearance. Seemingly, nothing can stop this big man, Wrath.
Well, I tell you, not a drop kick from a small man like that in the second time. Easily sidestepped by Wrath. Look at the power here. Just dumped him like a baby here. He just picked him up like nothing.
Totally dominant since his return to World Championship Wrestling. The originator of a move called the Meltdown that has helped Wrath compile quite a winning streak since coming back to WCW.
The size, but the demeanor to go with it as well. Sends Hawkins Moore in. Exploding out of the boxes that time. Legs springing forward and dropping the man down.
It's very impressive for a man about 6'7", over 300 pounds. Wrath moves like a lightweight.
Pump handle time. That means, and the fans react to it.
They've seen this before.
The Meltdown rapidly becoming.
Oh, watch the hand.
One of the most feared and famous moves in World Championship Wrestling. Nick Dinsmore's not going to get up. It's over.
Incredible the way he snaps off that slam, Larry.
Very dismal for Dinsmore.
Wrath, your winner, destroying the competition once again. And not finished yet. The attitude to go with it, still to come in this program. Ric Flair, he is here.